up out of there.
Ain't nothing but a gangsta party.
Oh shit.
You done fucked up, man.
You done put two of America's most wanted in the same motherfucking place at the same motherfucking time. Y'all niggas about to feel this. Break out the champagne glasses and the motherfucking condoms.
Good morning and welcome to Beast and Cousin Ostra's first game back in 2023. Match day 10 versus Harrow FC. Unfortunately, it was not recorded. However, Beast and Cousin Ostra won that game 5-0 in the League Cup quarter-final and advanced through to the semi-final. This is match day 11, it's in the league, and it's Beast and Cousin Ostra versus Stapleford Town Sundays. The last time these two met, Beast and Cousin Ostra are rampant and they won 8-0. Let's see how they fare today. Early part of the game then. And the ball's with Beeston and Bale as they look to break away. He fires it out to the left-hand side to Aidan Brady. He looks up. There's only Greeny inside the box, but he fires in a nice ball. Stabo header. It goes out for an early Beeston corner. Beeston quite dangerous throughout the season with corners. And it's Keza. Keza stood over the corner. He whips in a lovely cross normal. Let's see if he can deliver. Keza fires it in. Oh, but it's gone straight through the crowd and no one was there. Keza put the man down. Oh, the ball fell through to Aidan. Aidan Brady through. 1-1. The gaffer's got his hands in his hair. Must be 1-0. Oh. AB11. Tagger mate who will miss this. Early chance for Aidan Brady and he doesn't take it. The gaffer can't believe it. It should be 1-0 Beeston. Another Beeston corner, and it's Keza stood over it once again. Keza delivers it, better ball. Greeny, header, free. 1-0 Beeston. Greeny in too much space, easy as you like. He ain't gonna miss from there. 1-0 Beeston. Ball's with Greeny then, he's dropped deep to retrieve the ball. He looks up, Keza makes it, what a ball that is by Greeny. Keza's through, he's got Oppo in the middle. Oppo's free, open goal. Oh my days, I can't believe it. It should be 2-0, what a miss. Ball back at the keeper's feet then, and it's Brownie. Plays it upfield towards Brady. Aidan Brady plays it inside towards the wall. Jack Upton. Jack Upton slides it back through to Aidan. Aidan knocks it off to Greeny. Greeny, through ball to Keza. Keza's through. Can he finish? Keza takes his shot. What a save by the goalkeeper. Brady's there again. Corner. Balls with Aidan Brady out on the left-hand side. Aidan Brady skips past one player. He puts in the ball. Mark Green's there with his head. But that's a poor effort and it's another chance gone. Oh, that's the skipper. Paul Ison, the Iceman. He intercepts the ball and he wins it back in the middle of the park. He lays it off to Aidan Brady. He's got options. He looks up. He slips in Jack Upton, the Wolf. Oppo looks up. He tries to get the ball in the box. He slides to Aidan's feet. Go! Oh, my days. Multiple hands on heads. How has he not scored? How is it only 1-0? Only Aidan Brady knows. As Beats wins the ball back this time. And he's landed with Keza. It's at Keza's feet. He skins one. He skins another. Oh, look at their magic feet. Oh, my God. He's taking the piss. Keza. Oh, that's another great save. And he's gone out for a corner. Dancing feet there by Keza. It's another Beeston Cousin Ostra corner then as they look to punish Stabo. It's been relentless. The ball's fell to Kobe. Jack Kenworthy. Can he finish? Jack Kenworthy. No! Another great save by the keeper. Beeston still camped inside the Stapleford half then. And the ball's with Jack Upton inside the box. He lays it off to Glenn Hurst. Should have shot first time. He gets his shot off. Another save. My days. Can we please put these shots away? And there's a rare touch for Brownie in this half. Stabo not had much of the ball and they tried to play their winger in, but Glenn Hurst is there. Hollywood Hurst, and he plays the Hollywood ball to Keza. What a touch. 1-2. Great bit of football. And Keza's through. Keza's down the wing. Keza, what could he produce? He puts it in the box. Ball's fell to Greeny. Oh, it's another chance wasted. Stabo free kick and it's pumped forward. Jack Kenworthy's there, but he's mistimed the header and Stabo are through. Can they score? No, what a save by Brownie. Ball's in the keeper's hand and he pumps it up in the sky, but Brady's underneath it. Here, boy. Oh, that was so high, he clicked a plane, but that was disgusting. Greeny shoots, cracks the ball. What a goal that would have been. Beeston really got to start taking these chances. This should be 6 or 7 nil up. It's only 1. And the ball's with Brady. Plays a lovely inside ball to Jack Upton on his weak foot. Left foot, strike, scores. Goal! What a goal. Sneaks in at the far post. It's that man, and he runs off to celebrate to his imaginary fans. Beeston 2-0. Stabo just can't get out of their half. It's wave after wave of attack from Beeston. And this time the ball's with Bale. Plays it inside to Brady. Will he slip him back in? No. He shoots, goes it alone. Poor shot. Another Beeston attack. And it's Bale. He clips it out wide to Greeny. Greeny chases the ball down. He's got Kessa with him. Greeny holds it up. Oh, back heel. Lovely little back heel there to Kessa. Kessa takes on his man. He drives inside the box. He looks up. Aidan Brady's there. Finally, gets off the mark. Lovely little team goal. It's Beeston 3, Stabo 0. Kobe over the free kick. And he plays it down the channel towards Brady. Brady on the ball. Comes inside. Trying to lose his man. The guy makes a tackle, but it falls to Beats. Beats to Ison. Look at Aidan. Aidan's making that run. He's continued his run. Ison finds it. Bit of luck. Aidan's through. One on one. Has to be. Quick fire double for AB11. He's on the score sheet. It's Beeston 4, Stabo 0. Ball's at Jack Kenworthy's feet, and he's looked up. Kessa slips it through to Aidan. Oh, he's forgotten the ball. Chance after chance this half for Aidan Brady. Deep inside the first half, it's still Beeston 3, Stabo 0. And the ball's at Glenn Hursby. He plays it through to Greeny. Greeny looks up. Aidan's through. And that's Ison winning the ball back again deep inside his own half. And he plays it out towards Bale. Bale on the ball, moves forward. The defender's backing off from him. That's not wise. Bale looks up, shoots, scores. Goal! What a finish. It's Beeston 4, Stabo 0. Bale cuts inside, gets his shot off, and it's a great finish. Stabo kickers back off then, and Aidan Brady's about to lose his head. Jesus Christ, AB, what the... Beeston's still pressing. It's been all them, all this first half. And especially this man. The ball's at his feet again. It's Kessa. Skips past one. Sends two more to the chip shop. Kessa, shut up. This guy has been having an unreal first half. The only thing missing for me is a goal. And I think that's about it for the first half. Yep, it is. The ref blows up his half-time whistle. It's Beeston 5, Stapleford Town 0. It should be and could be easily double figures. Beeston need to be more clinical in the second half and kill this game off completely. Half time down here then this morning, and there's local Long Eaton Sunday League legend Neil Palmer. He's out this morning to watch us, and there he is out there shaking hands with a few of his old players. Always nice to see Neil. Just the one change for Beeston at half time then, and that's Trish, you see, running out there. He's coming on, he's replacing Bale. Second half then about to get underway. Beeston surely will be looking for more goals and a clean sheet. Beeston starting the second half, and they finish the first half, and that's camped inside the Stabo half. And the ball's bouncing around the edge of their 18-yard box. And Kezza slipped in Uppo. Uppo looks up. He's played it across to Triss. 6-0. Triss comes off the bench and scores within 2 minutes of the second half. Stabo in possession. But Aidan Brady's read the ball. He's intercepted. And he drives forward. If he looks up, he's got Uppo out on the left-hand side. He can slide it across to Triss again for another tap-in. But goes it alone. And that's a save, and it's a Beeston corner. Beeston throwing, and he's thrown in towards Ison's feet. Ison lays it back out towards Kobe. Kenworthy's at the back stick. Hands in the air if Kobe can find him. Kenworthy, back stick, header, goal! Beeston 7, Stabo 0. What a ball that was by that wonder of a left foot. It just feels like how many are Beeston going to win by now? The game's done. Credit to Stabo though. They're 7-0 down and they're not giving up. And they're on the ball, and they're on the attack. And he's beat the offside trap, and he's through. One on one. Can Stabo get a consolation goal? No! Michael Brown, not much to do. Called into action, makes the save. on the attack again. And the ball's at Trissa's feet, dancing around the edge of the 18-yard box. He lays it off to Greeny. Greeny, oh, it turns his man. Oh, lovely ball out towards Uppo. Uppo sprays it across the edge of the 18-yard box, but no one's there. And Beaster make a substitution. That's Ryko. He replaces the skipper, Paul Eisen. And there's Ryko's first touch of the game. He plays it inside to Greeny. Keza screaming for it. Greeny finds him. Keza looks up. Another shot on target. Still no goal for Keza this morning, though. Stabo trying to clear it, but it's only fell as far as Jack Upton. Oh, he's doing his best impression of a dolphin with a beach ball there. Bit of magic. He finds Aidan Brady. Uppo's in the box. He wants it back. Turns. Shoots. Oh, has he fumbled it? Uppo wants the goal. It's not going to count. And that's another one for the ever-growing Aidan Brady quote book. Listen, lads, I'm sure he'll tell you he meant it. As the ball slipped in towards Jack Upton, Jack Upton slides it past the keeper. Goal! 8-0 Beeston Kozanostra, and it's a double on the day for that man, the Wolf, Jack Upton, as he runs off to celebrate. Ball with Tris then. Tris lays it off to Shep. Shep, he looks up. He finds Jack Kenworthy, slips his man. Jack Kenworthy looks up. He finds Uppo. Uppo's on the right-hand side this time. His body's in the box. Can he deliver? Jack Upton. Oh, it's foul at the feet of Mark Green. Right foot. No, switches to his left foot. Boom! 9-0. Beeston Kozanostra. Double on the day for that man, Mark Green.
Get going again, lads. You shit.
Nine nil down, only 5 or 10 minutes left in this game, but fair play to Stabo. They have not given up, and they're on the attack. It's a rare one, and their winger, it skins a man. He pulls it back inside the box, chance of a consolation goal, and he skies it over the bar. Brandy launches the ball forward then, and Stabo can't clear it, and it's at the feet of Tris. Tris lays it off to Uppo, outside of the foot towards Aidan Brady. The Stabo defender gets there. Oh, he bounced and he's dropped to Greeny. Go! 10-0, Beeston Kozanostra, and that's a hat-trick on the day for Mark Greeny. Balls with Greeny. Greeny, out to Uppo. Uppo, nice little 1-2 there with Aidan Brady. Aidan Brady's gone back inside the box. Ball finds him. Can he get his hat-trick? Oh my days. AB 11. He could have got a double hat-trick today. He really could have. He's been at the heart of everything good. Just his finishing has not been clinical. Ryko with a throw into Uppo. Uppo looks up. Oh, that would have been a screamer. Yeah, and Ryko wanted the assist if he went in, that's for sure. Stapleford still refusing to give up despite being 10-0 down. And they're on the attack. And Jake Shep, he's mistimed his tackle. And Stabo, they're through. 1-1. Can they get a goal? No. That's a great recovery by Shep. And I think Kobe's gone down. And I think he's pulled his hammy. I don't know about this dude, but Brady's going to show us his. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, that's magic from Brady. Magic. And he slips in Jack Upton. He's got Mark Green to the left if he needs him. No, he decides he don't. He cuts inside. He gets his shot off. And that's another save by the keeper. Beeston Kozanostra corner and the Wolves stood over it.
Come on, Aidan. Stop.
And that's the Iceman reminding Aidan to let the referee go. He says it's always nice to greet a fan. The ref tells him it's the closest anyone's got to him all game. Must be a matter of seconds left in this game. There can't be long left. With that being said, I'd like to award today's man of the match to Keza. And there it is. The ref's blown up his full-time whistle. It's finished Beeston Kozanostra 10, Stapleford 10-0. On another day, Beeston could have hit these for 20+. They were just not clinical enough. But fair play to Stabo, never giving up all game.